We got the Peggy's thinking we're a real threat. We got to lean into that now, or else we lose.
Good night. Oh my God, okay.
Lord, if today is truly the day you want to call me home, let me die in a pile of grass. Finders keepers, huh? That could have been worse. Every little bit helps. Thank you.
Fire on that wall! Push it forward!
What the f-
I'm alert!
Oh wow, his helmet.
Thank you.
The hell? He just run over a bear? Or an elk or something?
I heard the cultists making a racket at the garage. They gotta be using that place to build up their convoys.
How do, ma'am?
Deeply of sin.
Okay, apparently he wasn't joking about not getting out. That note. Oh fuck, jeez. What the fuck? Damn it, Boomer. What the hell did he pull a point a gun at me for? What the fuck are you guys' problem? I'm gonna shoot you guys if you keep pointing your weapons at me.
go.
Hey there, gorgeous.
How you doing, bud?
Probably ain't gonna point your gun at me anymore now, are ya? Oh God.
Big time.
Oh my God. Okay, why wouldn't it open fucking fire?
Stunt now known
as the baptism of fire, hurtling at speeds never attempted by mortal men. Clutch's body most likely ignited due to a blood alcohol level of 0.67. Despite man and machine being fused together by the heat of a thousand suns, Clutch managed to survive by maneuvering his vehicle into a nearby stream. Witnesses to the feat assumed he had perished, but Clutch Nixon emerged from the water like a phoenix rising from the ashes, and a legend was born. To this day, it remains a feat never once repeated.
Jerome is selfish and misguided, and if he were a true man of God, his people wouldn't have left him in the first place. You, deputy, will still confess your sins, because this is the will of the Father.
Damn, think I split my pants.
Help! God, please! I don't want to die! Help me!
Dodd's Dumps was getting renovated when the cult forced it to close. Owner wasn't too happy about it. Heard he made a deal with the local resistance to store some supplies in there. It's honestly a bit of a death trap. So be careful while you're there. Won't forget what you did in Falls End. Dodd's Dumps was getting renovated when the cult forced it to close. Owner wasn't too happy about it. Heard he made a deal with the local resistance to store some supplies in there. It's honestly a bit of a death trap, so I'd be careful while you're there.
That's how you do it. of interest. I hope you're ready to serve your country. I know who you are, Deputy, and I know what you're doing. My name is Special Agent Willis Huntley. The man in charge has been monitoring Eden's Gate for some time. I've been sent by the highest authority to handle it. But the prepubescent eggheads at Langley tell me this is a sharing economy now. And before we help you, you need to do something for us. So just like a fine Turkish sauna, you scratch my back and I'll scratch yours. Pardon my French. Get in my car and I'll explain. I was on vacation visiting all 50 states in ascending order of patriotism when I got a call. The call. I've been sent here on a special mission from the big man himself. Jesus, tap dancing Christ, just saying that gets me semi-erect. Pardon my French. I need to recover a tape that, if released, could make him look bad to the public. I tracked it here to a member of Joseph's happy family. He stashed it somewhere. And that's where you come in. I'm gonna lure out our man, then you're gonna follow him back to his hiding hole and get the tape back for me. Do this for your country, and your country will solve your little cult problem for you. I've never seen a cult use a corporate structure before. Usually it's just one guy. Eden's Gate has a CEO and executives. It's Cult Incorporated. This tower. Get rid of all these doomsday hippies for me.
Pretty good.
Really, everyone I've heard that's played it has all said the opposite. Every single one of them.
Well, is it for you?
I mean, it's kind of a Grand Theft Auto ripoff, basically. In first person instead of third.
Great job, Deputy. Now meet me in that tower.
Not cool.
So
I don't know. It's yeah. It's got a multiplayer.
Oh wow! Really? Man, I remember trying the first Far Cry on multiplayer. Oh god, did that suck? I like the franchise all the way up to Far Cry 2, and even there, that, yeah, they kind of lost me. The first Far Cry was
attention,
the bomb,
comrade.
Man.
The bed has
the
been
story
wet.
Was original.
Repeat, the bed has been wet.
Thing.
Who is this? How did you get on this frequency?
I've never played any of them.
I have time to explain, but your bunker is compromised.
Yeah, the first
you
one, the story
fast.
Was really enticing.
I'm at the boys' house. Send me a chopper.
But sadly,
it
is an EA game,
time,
I believe, if I recall.
That
and it was a very
house.
Short
the target
story.
Get in,
I believe
and
you
they'll
can,
lead
like,
you down
plow
the yellow
through
brick road.
And, like,
Remember, as ironic as this may sound, this is not a wet work season. Surveillance only. Do not engage the target unless instructed. There's the
hope you've had decent gun safety classes, Far Cry 2 kind of touched base right on Far Cry 1, but they added some really strange shit. Where exactly are you guys planning to go with this? And in Far Cry 3, it was just, yep, that's what we thought.
Go, deputy.
A complete flop. And I haven't heard much from Far Cry 4. That's pretty much where I gave up on. So by now, I caught Shroud. And he was like, make my comments negative. Dude, you should go see this movie screen. Thing's almost 70 gigs too.
All right, let our man get into the chopper. Remember, we still need to find where he's hiding the tape. Any idiot with a stick can pull off wet works. Espionage is what separates us from the animals. Clear the area. We're looking for a hard copy, likely an old VHS tape.
kid. I've got bigger fish to fry, and this little bearded uprising is suddenly below my pay grade. The American way used to mean a deal was a deal, but we live in a new America now. I know you're wishing for a handout, but that's just how it is. Reminds me of something my grandmother used to say to me. Wish in one hand, shit in the other, and see which one fills up first. Ah, I miss her. See you around, kid.
twice as fucking hard now.
Every channel plays the same shit. Oh. Oh.
Is not the will of the father. Take them to John. He's ready to hear their confession. My parents were the first ones to teach me about the power of yes. One night, they took me into the kitchen and they threw me on the ground. And I experienced pain after pain after pain after pain. And when I didn't think I could take any more, I did. Something broke free inside. I wasn't scared, I was clear. I looked up at them. I started to laugh. All I could say was, yes. I spent my entire life looking for more things to say yes to. I opened every hole in my body, and when those were filled, I created more. But it was Joseph who showed me just how selfish I was being. Always receiving, always taking. The best gift isn't the one you get, it's the one you give. Giving takes courage. Courage to own your sin, to etch it onto your flesh and carry its burden. And when you have endured, when you have truly begun to atone, to cut it out like a cancer and display it for all to see. My God, that's courage. I'm going to teach you courage. Teach you how to say yes, so you can confront your weaknesses, confront your sins. You will swim across an ocean of pain and emerge free. For only then can you truly begin to atone.
Jesus, this guy's insane.
So who wants to go first? Which one? Yes. Yes. You're not gonna regret this. I promise. Now, before we begin, I think it's only proper that Deputy Hudson goes back to her room. Confessions are meant to be private, after all. Here to take your life. I'm here to give it to you. I'm going to open you and pour your worst fears inside. And as you choke, your sins will reveal themselves.
thank John for purging me of my sins. I understand now that my sins have gotten in the way of me being the man I want to be. I thank him. I want...
Jesus.
Faith created her angels, but she never did treat them all that well.
I'm here, please. Open the gate. I'll do anything you want.
Thank you.
your soul, because in the end, you'll still be empty. And I'll be waiting right here. We both will. From this place, let them run, let them hide, for no matter where they go, God will guide us to them. See, that is the power of yes. There's nothing more you can do here, deputy. I'll come for you when you're good and ready.
you're able-bodied, I could use a favor. Name's Wendell Redley. But most folk call me Red. Wouldn't typically bother a stranger about this, but old Dutch speaks so highly of you. So, there was a group of us from here served in Vietnam together. Things we seen in that jungle? We made a pact that if something like that were ever to happen in our country, we'd be ready. Put together quite a collection. Guns, ammo, gear. Called it our Freedom Fund on account it was going to make sure we stayed that way until the grave. But that was a long time ago. Now the only one left still breathing is me. The gear's locked up safe and sound, but we split the code amongst ourselves, etched each number on the back of our lighters. I'd take care of this myself if I were 10 years younger, but now, hell, I'd just get myself killed for no good reason. I need your help finding those lighters. Bring them to me, and I'll let you take your pick from our stash. I'll be goddamned if I'm gonna let this fucking cult burn my country to the ground.
About the only thing I'm good for is being right about that.
Someone told me the cult burned Sunrise Farm to the ground. Serves the owners right for selling out to John. I bet the cult's just helping themselves to all that food now.
One of these damn vultures gobbled up the key to my barn. Look, it's a long story. Let's just say I was, indisposed. You gotta help me. I'm a lousy shot when it comes to moving targets. Shoot down those vultures. One of them has to have the key.
Mm-hmm.
I'm no good with breeds, but your buddy here is a...
In retrospect, maybe I should have prepped more. Starvation with the rest of Hope County.
All right, Deputy. It's time to boost tea levels and give the people that little extra fire they're craving. Right now, we serve our Montana tender groins a lot of ways. Baked, fried, boiled, steamed, cured. Hell, we even got a signature dessert. Nuts cream. But that ain't gonna cut it this year. We need something new, something exciting. We're gonna put together a spread that would make a TV chef's asshole pucker. Three new ways to enjoy that swinging beef. Shredded, roasted, and blue. First two are simple. Tractor mulcher and some fire should do the trick. The third one? Well, let's just say interrupting a bull when he's playing hide the salami is one of the most dangerous things you can do. But that's what makes it taste so good. When you're done, bring the goods back to me and we'll kick the festival off with a bang.
So if I understand that right, I gotta kill a bull while it's fucking a cow? What?
Say what?
I don't know, dude.
Ladies,
man, this is the most awesome game I've ever played.
Something that's either real smart or real stupid. I love you both at the same time. I got John Cena on the ropes, so I'm going for broke.
Thank you.
John bought up all the businesses around here and promised us jobs. But the only people who got work were cultists.
Death from above.
You know, I can teach you. A life lesson, if you're interested. The old saying, teach someone to fish.
We need streaming TV and streaming. Nice work, Deputy. A lot of people have good memories of Sunrise Farms. It'll go a long way in boosting morale. Sounds like the place still needs some help, though. Getting some chatter about the irrigation system not working. See if you can lend a hand.
Thanks for strengthening our numbers.
Help me fix this place up? The cult sure made a mess of this place. The irrigation system's wrecked pretty badly. There are pieces of pipe scattered all over this place. I found most
of
them.
For what you
think there's three missing still. Find them and stick them back where they belong. Then Sunrise Farm will be good as new.
Mary May sure talking about you.
Gotta count your blessings.
Oh,
long as it hasn't been eating meat itself. I remember Mike bragging about his car. Thing was a beast. Now that he's gone, I just want to haul it out of Sunrise Threshing and ram it down the throats of every Peggy I see.
Thank you. Flag him!
Thank you.
Eat. Getting hungry.